Good morning students, how are you all? Fine, I hope all are fine and safe at home. Today we are going to start our second class. Last class we were discussed about primary memory and also the classification of primary memory, which are RAM and ROM. Today we are going to discuss about the secondary memory. Do you know what is secondary memory? We are using secondary memory for storing data permanently. Okay, there are two more names for secondary memory. First one it is auxiliary memory and second one it is external memory. Okay, there are lot of secondary storage devices which is used to store data permanently. Before starting the secondary storage devices, we can discuss about the measuring units of memory. Okay, do you know which is the basic unit? That is bit. Okay, one bit is either 0 or 1. Okay, 8 bits together called 1 byte. 1024 bytes is equal to 1 KB, which is kilobyte. 1024 KB is 1 MB, megabyte. 1024 MB is equal to 1 GB, gigabyte. And 1024 GB is equal to 1 TB, terabyte. Okay, these are the basic measuring units of data. Now we are going to discuss about the advantages of secondary storage devices. Here we are mainly discussing 3 advantages. First one it is, we can store large amount of data. By using the secondary storage device, we can store large amount of data. Bulk amount of data we can store in secondary storage device. Second one, we can easily transfer data from one computer to another computer with the help of secondary storage device. And third one, we can easily change or delete the data which we stored in our secondary storage devices. So these three are the main advantages of using secondary storage devices. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the secondary storage devices. The first one it is hard disk. The hard disk is also known as hard drive. Okay, either hard disk or hard drive we can say. It is enclosed within the CPU box. Okay, it is enclosed within the CPU box. All the softwares and saved data which is being used in a computer system is saved inside the hard disk. The capacity of hard disk is 250 GB to 1 TB. Okay, the minimum capacity of a hard disk is 250 GB and the highest capacity is 1 TB. We can also externally attach a hard disk to the computer, which is called external hard disk. Okay, next one, the second secondary storage device is CD. Have you heard CD? Do you know what is the full form of CD? It is compact disk. Okay, have you seen CD? Okay, there are 3 types of CD. First one it is CD-ROM. Second one CD-R and third one CD-RW. Okay, now let's discuss each one. First one it is CD-ROM. I think you know what is the full form of ROM, right? Read only memory. Okay, these CD-ROMs are preloaded CDs. Okay, either music or data, it is preloaded into the CD and we can only read the data or we can only play the music or read the data. We cannot erase any data on the CD or we cannot save extra data to the CD. Okay, that is CD-ROM. Second one, it is CDR, which is recordable. CD recordable. Okay, it is a recordable CD. Once we written data into the CD, we cannot erase anything from it. Okay, and also we cannot rewrite. Third one, it is CDRW, which is rewritable. As the name mentioned, we can rewrite the data. Okay, we can rewrite again and again after erasing the stored data. Okay, for using the CD, we need a CD-ROM player attached to the computer. Okay, next one, it is DVD. Do you know what is the full form of DVD? It is digital versatile disc, DVD. It is looking same as the CD, but there is a difference in the case of storage capacity and the quality of CD. Okay, whatever we are storing in the DVD, in the case of quality and capacity, it may differ from the CD. Okay, up to 4.7 GB data we can store in a DVD. Okay, by the appearance or by looking, the CD and DVD are same, but there is difference in the case of storage capacity and also quality. Next one, it is Blu-ray disc. Okay, the Blu-ray disc also have the same shape of CD, but it is differ in color. Okay, it is the latest among the storage disc, and also it is the superior of all the storage discs. It has the highest storage capacity, up to 25 GB data we can store in a Blu-ray disc. We cannot play the Blu-ray disc in the CD-ROM player. For using the Blu-ray disc, we need a Blu-ray disc player. Okay, and the last one, it is USB drive. The USB drive is also known as flash drive, pen drive or thumb drive. Okay, it is very small and compact storage device. Okay, but we can store huge amount of data. It is very small, but we can store huge amount of data. It has variety of storage capacity, and it's range from 4 GB to 32 GB of data. And this USB is inserted to the USB port of the computer. Every computer should have a USB port. Nowadays in TV also we have USB port. By inserting the USB port, we can watch movies, right? It is very durable device and keep the data very safe and secure. Very safely we can store data in USB. Okay, we can rewrite the data. Whatever we stored in USB, that we can rewrite. We can erase the data and again we can rewrite data. So these all are the different types of secondary storage devices. First one, it is hard disk. Second one, compact disk. Third one, digital versatile disk. Fourth one, Blu-ray disk. And the last one, USB. I think all of you understood what we discussed today. You have to do one thing, just read the chapter for one time. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can contact me. Just read the whole chapter for one time. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.